Hello everyone, welcome to the GeoEcologist. I am Dr. Krishnanand and you have been watching my videos on oceanography and several other videos related to geography. In this session on oceanography, we are going to talk about the density distributions in the oceans. But not just that, we are going to learn about the relationship of temperature, density and salinity as well. So before we go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do share the videos with others as well. So now, after we have already learned about the ocean's temperature distribution, its factor, then we learned about the ocean's salinity distribution and several factors. Today, let's understand about the ocean's density distributions and factors associated with it. So, density is what? It refers to the amount of mass per unit volume. So, remember, mass per unit volume is what we say is density of a substance. So it is usually measured in what? Gram, amount of mass, that is gram per cubic centimeter of volume, and is expressed as gram per cubic meter. So remember, this is the unit. Now, when we are learning about ocean's density, the quantity is about water. So remember, the density of pure or distilled water, we say, is exactly 1 gram per cubic centimeter. But at a given temperature, that is 4 degrees C. And why at 4 degrees C? Because in comparison of the water at its densest. Now remember, water is at its densest limit at this temperature. That is important to remember. That's why we take this temperature 4 degrees C for the comparison. So distilled water is 1 gram per cubic centimeter at 4 degrees C, and this is important to remember. Now, if we compare the distilled or the purest water to the salt water, that is where we can understand how much more or how much less is there. So the sea water carries dissolved substances, as we know, and that is what we have already learned in the salinity as well. That is the salt part. So its density is higher, obviously, right, than the pure water. So what happens? The average density of seawater is 1.0278. Right? So 1.0278 gram per cubic centimeter, and this is what you say is that from pure water it is increased, and how much? About 2 to 3% higher than the density of pure water at the same temperature, that is 4 degrees C temperature. So because of the density factor, and remember, we are talking about the purity, so pure water is one value, but as it goes impure, it means there are more dissolved substances, the density is increasing. Now let's elaborate further more. So the density is very much important physical property of seawater, and obviously because of the salt content, right? So it becomes one of the most important physical property, and we have learned in details in the salinity video as well. If you have not watched the video on ocean salinity, please go to the playlist of oceanography and do watch the video on salinity, where we have discussed in details the properties of saline water, right? So because of this, it determines the dynamics of the ocean water. Remember, dynamics is basically movement of ocean water, horizontal movement, vertical movement. All these movement of water is triggered by this factor, that is density factor, which is closely linked with the temperature as well as salinity factors. So what happens? Seawater will sink. It basically means it will subside, the subsidence process, it will go down, and hence downward vertical movement of seawater will be triggered, right? In one case, that is when it is sinking, while if it is floating, if it is lighter, it is not heavier, it is less dense, then floating portion will be the expansion portion, right? So it will be expanding, it will be horizontal movement. So remember that density factor is linked to the sinking or subsidence as well as the floating and horizontal movement. That is why we term that density is one of the most important physical property of seawater that triggers or it determines the dynamics, right? So as per rule, the relatively lighter seawater, now remember, relatively lighter is less denser, that is what is lighter. So it floats and moves horizontally, whereas heavier water sits down or sinks down. Right? It triggers the vertical movement. So now, if we understand these two important points, the controlling factors of density are these three factors. What are the controlling factors? One is temperature, one is pressure, one is salinity. So temperature, when we say, it is about thermal expansion and contraction. If it is cool, it will contract. If it is hot, it will expand, right? Similarly, pressure. If it is putting more pressure, it is compressing it. If it is less pressure, it is releasing it, right? So that is important in terms of compression. And third factor we have already discussed in details in salinity, that is addition of dissolved salt. In a given amount of water, more salt, it means more dense, it means more heavy, it sits down, right? So that is how salinity, pressure, temperature, right? So this is how it is linked to the density of seawater. Now let's elaborate further more. So first important thing that we need to understand is the relationship between temperature and density of the seawater. So temperature and density of seawater on an average are inversely linked. Remember, there is an inverse relationship between temperature and density. So it means higher the temperature, lower the density. That is what inverse relationship is. So remember, T is inversely proportional to density, right? In average condition, in normal condition, not in anomalous condition, because it is a dynamic phenomena. So there can be exceptions, but this is one, what we say is generalization. This is an average work that we understand, right? So lower the temperature, higher the density, right? So in this condition, what is important? Where is the higher temperature? Remember, in tropics, it is higher. So what is happening? The higher temperature is there and it is lower in density. That is why if heat is there, expansion happens and movement of water is there, right? So what happens? Sea water is heated through insulation, and when more insulation is received, the sea surface expands, right? Sea water expands because of temperature factor. So this is called thermal expansion, right? And remember what happens due to this? Density is now low there, right? Then on the other hand, low temperature causes cooling of seawater, right? And what happens? There is a contraction. So that is what thermal process is. Expansion, contraction, resulting in the more density, more salts coming together, contracting. So that is what will happen here. The heavier or heaviness will increase. So it is significant to point out that role of temperature in controlling seawater density is more pronounced in lower latitudes. And it is but obvious that maximum of the tropical and subtropical seas which receive more insulation, obviously there will be lesser dense water, right? So temperature is important factor, and remember, importance of temperature in controlling seawater density decreases towards pole vault. Remember, as we go towards the pole, the temperature also reduces and its importance also reduces in terms of density, right? So that is important point to remember in terms of relationship between temperature and density. Then let's talk about the second relationship, that is pressure and density relationship. So it is directly positively correlated or proportional. It means pressure is directly proportional to the density. It means pressure increases, density increases. Pressure decreases, density decreases, right? So this is what we say through compressive effect. Now remember, compression, it means if this is mass of water and it is being pressed in, right? It means its molecules are coming closer to one other, and that is where density will increase, right? So this is important here. So it may be mentioned what? Unlike air. Now remember, not like air. Seawater, even remember, water is not much compressible. This is important to remember, that water is not much compressible. It is not like air. Rather, it is nearly incompressible. So almost compressibility factor is very less. That is important in terms of if you compare with the air. So don't get confused with the air pressure and water pressure relation. Remember, seawater is less compressible than air in comparison. Hence, it exerts negligible control over seawater density. Although there is a relationship between pressure and density, but this relationship is negligible, right? The pressure is considered as minor factor. This is important point to remember. And when we want to study the example of this pressure, we can understand it through the trenches or deepest of sea bottoms, where there is 5% higher density than that on the sea surface. So just 5% of difference, right? Pressure on sea surface is far lesser than that at a given depth. So this is just 5% change, right? In the deepest of trenches, if you observe, that is what it is supposed to be, a minor factor to remember. So pressure and density are positively correlated, but pressure is just a negligible factor or very minor factor in terms of the density control, but still it has a control. So that is a factor to remember. Then the third important point, which we have already discussed in the entire video, in the last video, that was on salinity. So salinity and density relationship, let's understand, salinity is directly positively related to seawater density. So more saline, more dense. That is what we have learned, right? So salinity increases, density increases. Salinity decreases, density decreases, right? This is important. So this is because of the dissolved salt. And remember, if this is a particular area, if there's a particular mass of water, if there are more salts, it means that it is more dense, right? So that is the simple factor. It is also important to note here that salinity factor sometimes offset by temperature factor. Now, temperature factor also, remember, is linked to the salinity factor, and that's why it will in turn change the density of that particular mass of water, right? So that is important. So as already described, that density of pure water is 1, whereas density of seawater at 4 degree is 35, as we already know, right? And salinity is 1.028 gram per cubic centimeter, right? So remember, this is important, that pure water, which is valuing here in terms of density, is 1, and saline water, is density is more. Obviously, the salinity content is also 35 ppt, right? So remember, salinity increases, density value is also increasing, and that's why fresh water floats over saline water. This is the relationship that we have studied, that fresh water will float over saline water because it is lighter, right? And also there is a role of temperature that we have already discussed in terms of density, right? So this is how temperature, salinity, density are linked together, right? That's why it is important to remember. So if you want to draw a diagram for your answer writing, this is one diagram that I find fit. So if you see different cases, first is lower evaporation, higher rainfall case. So what happens here? Here evaporation is less, rainfall is more, right? So what happens? Salinity will go down. Why? Because more water is being added to the system. So salinity will be lesser. So density will also be lesser, right? That is important to remember. Then if there is higher evaporation case and lower rainfall case, obviously water is evaporating. So salt content is getting condensed in that particular place. It is concentrated. So salinity value will go up. It means density value will also go up. And that's why the water will become heavy and water will sink down, right? That is the first case. Now, if you see high salinity plus low temperature case, right? Density will automatically go up because salinity is high, temperature is low, so evaporation will be low, and that's why heavy water, it will sink down, right? Now let's look at this case, less heat from sun near the poles. So what happens? Obviously, temperature is less, and less temperature means less evaporation, right? So this is important, and density will be higher, right? And water will sink down. Right? Similarly, in this case, more heat from the sun in tropics, it means what is there? More temperature is there. It means more evaporation is there. So density is actually going down, right? Because it is less dense, it is expanding. So what will happen? The water will rise. So this is how you can summarize it in one diagram if you want to have the relationship of temperature, salinity and density. That is important to remember here. Then if you want to stratify the oceans on the basis of density, you can stratify it into three parts. That is surface layer, that is lowest in density, lighter air is there in the upper part. So 100 to 200 meters thickness, right? It is called photic zone. Remember the photons. So light penetrating zone is there, and it is about 2% of total volume of the ocean water. Right? So this zone is illuminated. It has more phytoplanktons. It is rich area, right? So it has less density, right? And less density also, remember, it is linked to less salinity, right? Then what we have is the pycnocline layer. The word pycno basically symbolizes density. It means density. So it has sharp density gradient. Now remember thermocline and halocline. Similarly, you have the same layer where you have from this 300 to 1000. This layer also is linked to what? The temperature as well as your salinity factor. So that is where density is also linked. So this zone has sharp increase in density if you observe, right? Because this area, as you sit down, it goes down, right? Temperature is also less, right? And remember, this is where pycnocline layer is there. So sharp density gradient. Remember, it is 18% of total volume of ocean water. And what happens in pycno? basically is density change. And as already understood that pycnocline, thermocline, halocline, remember thermo is for heat, halo is for sharp decrease or increase in salinity. So pycno, thermo, halo, remember these are all linked to what? Density, then temperature, and then salt, that is salinity. So pycno, thermo, and halocline is the same layer, that is 300 meters to 1000 meter, where there is a sharp increase or decrease depending upon the situation, right? So deep bottom area is the third portion, right, in terms of stratification, and that is having a uniform density. Remember, 80% of the ocean total volume is there. Density is uniform, temperature is uniform, salinity is also largely uniform. So we have already learned about these relationships, right? So density stratification of oceans is into three zones: the upper zone, the intermediate, that is the middle zone, or we can say transition zone, which is called pycnocline, and then what we have is the deep or the bottom layer, right? So that is the density stratification of oceans.
So now when we have discussed in details the relationship of temperature, density, salinity, and several other factors associated to density, in the sessions to come we are going to learn about ocean deposits and several other concepts related to oceanography. So stay tuned, stay safe, keep watching.